Let's get this dope show on the road. Today, I'm going to be showing you guys the Spade grips. One of the more popular creations of mine, surprisingly. It looks very impractical, but given the alternatives, this is the best iteration so far of this idea. Commercially available options attached to the end of the buffer tube, and that is a no-go for something like this. It ends up being a foot longer than it needs to be. Awkward, stupid looking. We can make it a little bit less stupid looking. It attaches directly to the AR15 via the grip base. The spade grips go right behind the receiver, actually overlapping a little bit with the space between them set for the buffer tube, just like the old protrusion of the 1919, my original inspiration. And then I have a transfer bar for the triggers. Now, I've actually shaved into this one quite a bit. No AR15 fire control group is cut the same by brand, forge, even the trigger itself. They're all different shapes. There's going to be a lot of adjustment to do. But let's go ahead and get this thing installed on my demonstration rifle here. The demonstration rifle is my personal super dissipator, called so because the thing is very compact. The whole thing overall is something like 28 and a half inches from tip to butt. Alright, so now's the time for your best Terminator quotes. I've got this thing set up. I have a Strike Industries short buffer to really make this more compact, although any length buffer will work as it doesn't attach to the buffer. And your trigger paddle just goes right across it. I personally prefer the Strike Industries short buffer because it's about 2 inches shorter than your standard carbine length buffer, whereas a rifle buffer would be out to here. Now, I don't know if this would be considered a pistol or not, were you to make it be shorter, but it still keeps your overall length over 26 inches as well. If I went down to like a 7 or 8 inch barrel, this would probably be getting to AOW territory for overall length and having more than one grip or no pistol grip. Now, I would also recommend you put a riser on for your sights. This rear section here does use a bolt and nut that overlap on that last Picatinny slot to hold the top of the grip frame stable. So that does limit your choices for optics unless you go with a cantilever-style riser. On a spade grip weapon like this, it's always nice to have the optics nice and high up unless you just want to walk around, as I said, with the Schwarzenegger technique. So I've got this set up with a tripod mount, not one of my nice Magpul M-Lock ones, but just a shitty camera mount. Actually, the one that came with a tripod my GoPro's on right now. And then my front sight folds out of the way. Let's test fire this bitch. Alright, now I've got the platform outfitted with a CMMG 22LR conversion bolt. I'm not going to be letting loose a 50 Beowulf for the 5.56-1 in the house, of course. This one does not have the strength to force the trigger to reset. So when it goes to reset the trigger here, the paddle sticks forward. I've added a hole in the bottom so that you can set an additional spring to force the trigger to reset, or you can actually put your trigger finger in front of the paddle and just work the paddle back and forth like that, which is what I do with my 22LR. I always find the spring on the bottom gets grass in it. Alright, now that I've exceeded my dietary allowance of lead dust for the day, I hope you guys are ready to go build your own tripod mounted ARs. I've not got this one on the nice bog pod, but instead a $20 camera tripod, because the whole weapon itself probably only weighs about 7 pounds. Alright, so now that I feel you've been sufficiently entertained and informed, go out there and build your own horrible creations. Next time, I'm going to be covering the double-barreled AR-15 and a double-barreled spade grip to complement it. Ha, 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 ha.